Douglas Jemal was born in Brooklyn, New York, and came to Washington in 1966. He began his career in the retail trade with a small store on 7th Street Northwest. He soon expanded into the electronics and music business, and by the mid-1980s, he had created one of the most successful retail chains in the nation. The first parcel of land he purchased was 425 7th Street in 1981, and since then, he has focused on purchasing and developing distinctive commercial properties. His first property that planted the seed of historic preservation was the Parkin Shop in the Cleveland Park neighborhood.
What other people saw when they saw the Parkin Shop was an opportunity to develop a more ordinary Washington office building. And Doug saw an opportunity to take an old form, one of the first forms of the retail center in the age of the automobile, and rehab it and do a smaller scale renovation that would actually say something about the place and, you know, hopefully turn a profit too.
But I don't think he had had any experience in preservation per se, so it was sort of, you know, one step at a time with all of this, but it turned out he got it in the long run, and everyone was very happy with the results.
Other properties soon followed. Making a bet in the Chinatown area, Douglas began to have a vision. He began to incorporate historic preservation into his business strategy.
Washington's such a button-down town in so many ways. It's true of the real estate community. We don't have a lot of swashbucklers, and cities need that. We need somebody who says, hey, I don't care what the conventional wisdom says, I'm gonna try to do something else. Doug had a different attitude toward preserving the past and going with it to create something really cool for the present. And it's a much more organic view of preservation and development than I think other developers, at least at the time, were going with.
Next, Douglas redeveloped Chinatown Row, a section of storefronts with office space above, located near the site of the MCI Center. It attracted many restaurants into the retail space. The project won a merit award from the Washington chapter of the American Institute of Architects in the category of Architecture Historic Resources.
My observation of Doug would be, with respect to development, he always wants to do something really well. He wants to do it really well, and he wants to express the vision. He wants the vision to come alive. He wants all that stuff, and gets in his bulldozer, and he starts the bulldozer and he drives it to the end and he says, look, it's finished. And that's his vision. You can start anything, finish anything, and it's all gonna be successful, and don't bother me with the trivia.
After a competitive bidding process, the General Services Administration awarded the redevelopment project of LaDroite Block on F Street to Douglas Development. The site would eventually house the International Spy Museum and incorporate a new office tower and luxury apartments with the historic site.
Not sure where I first met him, but I do know that I was immediately impressed by him, not only because we both have the same hairstyles, but because he is such a vibrant, energetic, he always has a smile, and he's just a terrific person. Well, what I've never understood is how Douglas can make a good living, and I'm sure he does, and still do such great historic preservation work. Obviously, he's found a way to do both historic preservation and make a decent return, and I wish he would somehow bottle that secret and distribute it to all the developers at all the national conventions.
The Atlantic Building, Washington's first privately constructed high-rise building with elevator service, was integrated with six other historic buildings and facades into a 10-story trophy-class office building next to Ford's Theater.
Douglas is a developer. He wants to develop projects. He'd like to make these projects as big as possible. But he also has a sort of care and understanding for the history of Washington and is not willing to develop projects at all costs. He develops projects with an understanding that these sort of that history must be preserved.
The Woodward and Lothrop building on the corner of 10th and F Streets Northwest is one of Douglas Development's signature projects. Attaining its lasting form in 1927, the 10-story building held more than 400,000 square feet of retail space. Douglas acquired the property in 1999 and began redevelopment in 2003. The building now houses retailers H&M, Zara's, and Forever 21, as well as Madame Tussauds Wax Museum.
unlike, you know, the more typical approach, which is from the very, very beginning, you know, driven by numbers. I think with Douglas, it's really driven by love. It's driven by his love of a property. And basically, if he loves a property, typically it's because he can picture, he has a vision about it. He can imagine what he can do with it. And he's very confident. You know, he believes that ultimately others will buy into his vision and therefore the project will ultimately succeed. So that's really how he approaches his real estate, as far as I can see.
Douglas is a remarkable man and very outgoing. I think my back is still out of position from the hugs he's given me over the years. His interests are deeply steeped in the history of the city. He loves the old buildings, loves the old environments. He invested in the city 20, 30 years ago when people didn't, and he saved many parts of historic Washington, D.C.
Douglas Jemal has left a legacy for the city with many more projects, like the Citadel on Colorama Road and the Wonder Bread Factory in the Shaw neighborhood. He continues to project his vision with current development projects like the Hex Warehouse and U-Line Arena, preserving our past to help guide Washington into the future.